Following video is a review of the standard valve for the opener down pressure on a Borgo independent drill.
The oil coming out of our directional control valve on the opener P port is feeding the base end of the opener cylinders, and the R port is the return path when the openers are going down. Then it travels over to our downforce valve. Here is our downforce valve, and it comes in when the openers are going down on the P valve, so the P/VLV, and the return path is the R-VLV. So the pressure coming into this block is system pressure from the tractor, so it could be upwards of 3000 psi. Of course, we don't want to have that kind of pressure acting on our hydraulic cylinders to our openers. One cylinder per opener, and it is both your packing pressure and trip force. So we can't have that at tractor system pressure. So it first must go through a pressure reduction valve. That's this valve here. It's a two-part valve. It has an electrohydraulic section that receives variable voltage from the control box or the X35 monitor, telling it for more or less packing pressure. The manual override, jam nut and adjustable screw that just pushes this screw against the spring to adjust the pressure manually. There's a manual gauge up on the block indicating what the pressure is at. But make sure once you're done using the manual override that this screw is backed out all the way so this spool is allowed to fully travel across its range. So the oil comes in and then it goes out reduced on the PDRL, reduced for downforce. And then the return is here. What we're looking up on top here, directly behind the gauge, is a transducer. Then this sends a electronic signal back to the control box or monitor with the readout of the hydraulic pressure being applied to the opener cylinders. On the same side as the pressure reduction valve, there's a CXFA one-way check. What that does is, instead of the return oil going through the pressure reduction, so now we're pressuring up the rod end to raise those opener cylinders, it'll bypass the pressure reduction valve because of this one-way check. So that allows it to bypass on the return cycle. The standard Borgo drill control box looks something like this. There's various models, but they all have the same features. We have our raise lower. We have our gauge that receives its signal from the transducer on the control box block. We have our pack force increase and decrease, and our power on and off, sending power to the valve. I'll slide this out of the way a little bit so you can see the X35 controls for the same thing. We have our raise lower, same as the raise lower on the switch box. We have our pack force on off, same as the power on off here. We have our pack pressure increase decrease here. Would be the same as our increase decrease here. The X35 we can set to a controlled rate. And then our gauge receiving signal from the transducer on the control box is here. And the X35, it's here. Moving over to the other side of the valve, we have a COFA, it's a pilot operated check, and a CKEA, this is a counterbalance valve. We'll talk about this other circuit later. On this side of the circuit, these two valves work in conjunction with each other for regen. So what regen is, the ability to send some of the oil directly across to the other side of the cylinders without having to return all the way back to the tractor. So it's kind of a shortcut to speed the lower cycle. So how that works is there's always a pressure differential from rod to base end. When the pressure differential meets the requirements determined by this counterbalance valve, the PO check valve will open a path between rod and base end to speed up that lower cycle. So let's review what we've learned so far. We have our control box or X35 monitor that'll send variable voltage to this coil. So we have a control box, it's receiving signal from the increase or decrease on a control box. If we have the X35, we'd be decrease or increase or a fixed rate. That's sending variable voltage. So let's just zoom this in a little bit so we can focus in on the drawing portion of this. So receiving oil from the direction control valve on the P valve with the openers going down. This is at system pressure, so might be upwards of 3000 PSI. So it comes in, and then it's going to hit this pressure reduction valve. It's a two-part valve with an electrohydraulic section as well as a manual override. So it's going to be reduced and then fed to the base end of the opener cylinders to drop them down. And then when we go to raise it, so we're raising our openers, we're going to reverse the process, and now the oil will just simply bypass the one-way check and avoid going through any pressure reduction. Fairly simple circuit. We also have a function on here called regen. So what that is instead of all of this oil from the rod side having to go all the way back to the tractor, and then all of that oil to come in and fill up all those cylinders on the drill, we can shortcut some of the oil from the rod end over to the base end without having to go back to the tractor. So how does that work with the CBEA valve? So when we're in the raising position, we've got, and it'll bypass that, and away we go, right? So we're bypassing this counterbalance valve. When we're in the lowering position, it has to come to the counterbalance valve, and this is set at a fixed pressure so that it'll hold some return restriction. Why is that important? We have this PO check, this COFA. So as you can see by the ball, it's holding that closed by the pilot pressure. So number three is the pilot pressure. We follow that along and all the way back, we'll see that it's on the tractor side
of this counterbalance valve. So what that means is this should technically have very little back pressure on it. So if it doesn't have any back pressure, what is it going to do? It's going to allow that ball to shuttle over to the right and open up. When that opens up, because we have more pressure on this side of the counterbalance valve, it's going to allow that oil to go across to feed the down force. So the base end of those cylinders. Until the base end of the cylinders are actually producing pressure, and then they would close that ball. So a very simple circuit. Looks a little complex, but it's not that complex.